Latrobe City Councillor says the Valley is losing billion-dollar projects to other Victorian regions because companies can't get access to Gippsland's coal. It comes as the council unanimously supported a report aimed at exploring Hazelwood's market potential. Alexandria Zatzimakis reports.
Almost 6 months after Hazelwood's closure, talk remains over the future of its highly sought-after resource.
Councillor Graham Minimum has put up a motion that we actually get a report back on the uses of coal that can be used from the Driffield end of the Hazelwood mine, rather than just flooding the mine and letting all that coal go to waste.
The report will explore market interest in Hazelwood's coal, opening up the site to a range of opportunities. Councillor Harriman says there's already been keen interest from a number of companies.
We've had, obviously, the urethra plant that we've just lost to Bacchus Marsh, which was, from our understanding, a $1 billion project with hundreds of jobs. Because they couldn't get access to any coal in the Latrobe Valley, which seems ridiculous, they've now gone to Bacchus Marsh to access their coal.
The motion has gained support from some Latrobe Valley residents.
If we can utilise coal in a clean and efficient way, that's really great.
I think that that whatever's positive for this community, more including the whole Latrobe Valley, would be positive. It creates employment. That's a good thing, isn't it?
Others say options such as renewable energy should be explored.
Yes, coal may play a big part in Latrobe Valley for a long time, but what are the opportunities and what are we missing because we're only focusing on coal?
A spokesperson from ENGIE confirmed it's received a number of requests from companies asking to use Hazelwood's coal resource over the years, adding Latrobe City Council's request will be dealt with once it's received. Alexandria Zatzimakis, Nine News.